today I'll show you a detailed presentation regarding SWOT strategy and techniques. So my dear friends, before going to OER repositories, I think it will be better for you people to have a thorough knowledge regarding SWOT strategy and techniques, common SWOT strategy and techniques, because every day we face some problems of failing to retrieve quality result from the internet. So sometimes we use some queries and we do not get appropriate result. And when we refine the query, modify the query, then few results are coming out. So it is like a hit and try method. So sometimes we are not getting appropriate result from the internet. So we are searching on a topic and you are not getting appropriate result. And when you are modifying your query, you are refining your query, you are getting some appropriate result. So what difficulties you are facing and how effectively you can search internet and found resources. Today's I will cover mainly search strategy, or what must be the appropriate strategy of searching the internet, then effective search techniques. So by learning these effective search techniques, you will be able to search internet effectively. And then after delivering these common search techniques, I will switch over to OER, searching OERs. So first of all, let us see what strategy we have to adopt for searching. So before going to search any information retrieval system, we must have concept in our mind. We must have concept in our mind. We must identify the key terms or key topics or key concept before going to search the information retrieval system or any database or any search engine. Suppose I am going to search number of population in India. Suppose I am going to search number of population in India. So you see. So here I am putting the query India population under inverted comma. And I am getting the result like this. So this is 138 crores in 2020. So only I am putting India population under inverted comma and I am getting very good result. So whatever I want, I am getting immediately. So it is 138 crores by 2020 census. So if someone will write what is the population of India now in crores, what is the population of India now in crores, so someone will use natural language. Natural language means the language with which we are communicating with each other. If we are using this natural language, you see this is the result we are getting. So we are not getting the appropriate result in a single click. So you have to scroll down and you have to find out according to 2020 census what is the population. So this is wrong query. So you are not able to formulate the query. You are not selecting the appropriate keyword. So appropriate keyword is India population. So we have to put India population under inverted comma, then we'll get exact result. So this is the wrong process of searching. So what is the population of India now in crores? This is the wrong process of searching and this is the right process. So I am adopting the right strategy. I am selecting the right keyword for searching. So when we are going for searching, we have to identify the key concept rather than presenting the whole sentence. Rather than presenting the whole sentence or typing the whole sentence in the search box, I have to only identify the key terms. then I have to put that key terms in the search box and I will get appropriate result. So this is about selection of the key term or key concept. Then next step is to select the relevant databases and resources. Relevant databases or resources. Suppose I want population of India, so Google is the appropriate source, I will find it out. Suppose I belong to discipline of library and information science and I want total number of literature, total number of literature or articles published linked to the information technology application in library. Suppose information technology application in library, I want total number of publication published in the area of information technology application in library, then Google will not be the appropriate source for me. So what will be the appropriate source? Can anybody tell me what will be the appropriate source for me? If I am interested to find out, number of publication published from discipline of library and information science in the area of information technology application, then which will be the appropriate source for me? So, am I audible to all? So you see, suppose let me open a database of library and information science. Suppose this is the library information science technology abstract. So this is a source where all the library and information science collections or literatures are indexed. All the library and information science literatures are indexed here. So this is an indexing as well as abstracting database of library and information science. So if someone is interested to list the literature published in the field, then I can use this source. So selection of the appropriate source is essential. Then, after selection of the appropriate source, I have to combine the search with Boolean operators. So, you people may not have idea about Boolean operator. So, first of all, I will show you an example, then I will switch over to the step. So, here, is this visible to all? Is this visible to all?
Ma'am.
Okay. So health problems and air pollution. Health problems. Suppose someone is asking for the documents on topic health problems or health hazards or health complication because of air pollution. Health problems happening because of air pollution. So I have to find out key terms or key concept from the whole sentence. I have to find out key concept from the whole sentence or title. The key topic or key concept is health problem and air pollution. Then I have to connect these two, health problems and air pollution, with the connector AND. So AND is called Boolean operator. So without writing health problems, list of health problems because of air pollution, so because of, list of, these are all not required for searching. Not required for searching because these are not the key terms. So key terms are health problem and air pollution. Are you getting me? So I have to sort the document on the title list of health problems because of air pollution. So without writing the whole sentence, I can write health problems under inverted comma, and I will connect with AND operator and I will write air pollution. So this means I am instructing my search engine, or I am instructing Google to retrieve all the document having the phrase health problem and the phrase air pollution and the phrase air pollution. So here AND is called Boolean operator. Here AND is called Boolean operator. Okay. So some databases are having the facility of Boolean connector. Some databases are having the facility of Boolean connector. So here search engine Google is not having the facility of connecting this Boolean operator, and so we have to type the key term along with the operator AND. So let me show you example how other databases are having the facility of connecting with Boolean operator. So you see this database. So this database, Library Information Science Technology Abstract, so this database is having, suppose let us come to advanced search facility. Let us come to is asking for login. This is a free database. This is a free database. This must not ask for logging in. Yes, so you see, is it visible to all? Is it visible to all? Am I audible?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, yes, ma'am. So suppose this is an indexing database. This is an database, indexing database of library and information science. I want, tell me a topic, on which topic you want list of document. Tell me a topic. Please make this this an interactive section. So if you will not respond, then I will not follow you, and this will not be interesting for the presenter to present. So let me tell a topic on which you are interested to retrieve. Suppose I am interested to find document on information technology. Suppose I am searching for few documents on the topic information technology application in library and its impact on user satisfaction. Information technology application in providing library services and its impact on user satisfaction. So this is a big title. So I have to put few keywords. I have to choose few keywords or key phrases, and I have to connect all these key phrases with the Boolean operator AND. You see, Google is not having this facility of inbuilt AND or NOT search. So AND or NOT, these are the Boolean operators. And few databases are having this facility of inbuilt Boolean operators. So this is not there with Google. That is why we have to type in Google search box that we are connecting with, and you have to type, and if you are connecting with the operator, or you have to type, or, but here you do not have to type the operators. Only you have to type the phrase or keyword you are interested to search. So here I am interested to search on the topic information technology and library services. I want document on information technology application, information technology application in providing library services and its impact for user satisfaction. So let us type user satisfaction. So I am connecting all these phrases with AND operator. I am connecting this search with AND operator. And you see in the right hand side, these are the options available. So do you know these? What are the options? So here it is written author. So this is not author, this is a subject term or key term. So I cannot put author here. Suppose I want information technology, the phrase information technology must be in the title of the document. Then I can choose title. I want a document where the phrase information technology must be appearing. Then I can select title. Okay. Then suppose these two fields I am putting optional. Let us search. So only one result I found. I found only one result. What is the reason? Because AND is narrowing the search. When I am connecting these three phrases with AND operator, it is narrowing the phrases. That is why this is narrowing the search. This means this search technique meant for, we want all these phrases must be appearing in the document. All these phrases must be appearing in the document, and only single document is having all these three phrases. So this is narrowing the search. Let us make it or. You will get more result. Now you see the result will be more. Okay, so how many result you got? Is it visible to you all?
Yes, ma'am.
So how many result you are getting? How many result you are getting? 1716. So how are you getting this? How you got more result? Before it was only one result. Now you are getting 1716 number of result. How it happened? Because you changed the operator from AND to OR. So OR broadened the search. OR means you are instructing the system to retrieve the document or to search the document on topic information technology application and library services And user satisfaction may be there or may not be there. User, the phrase user satisfaction may be combined with the term or may not be combined. Okay, so the phrase library services may be there or the phrase user satisfaction may be there. Suppose you will make it, suppose you will delete this. Suppose library and automation. Let us make a simple search. Library and automation. So this much result is there. So how many results? 13,334. 334 results. So 13,334 result for the search library and automation. So library and automation means you want documents on topic library automation where the term library and automation appearing must be appearing within the document. If you will fix the appearance of the term in the title of the document. Suppose you will instruct the system to retrieve all the document having the term library in the title of the document. Again, you will instruct to have the term automation again in the title of the document. Then you will get very, very less result. So now the result was 13,334. Let us see. It will less the result. So how many results you are getting? Only 1,090. So before it was 13,334. Now it becomes 1,090 only. How it becomes? So what happened to it? How the results changed to 1,000? Number of results changed to 1,090. Number of results decreased. How it happened? Do you know this? Because you are specifying the database to retrieve the document which are having the term library and the term automation in the title of the document. You see this document, the title of the document is having the term library automation. You see the term automation and library is in the title of the document. Here you see this is having automation and library in the title of the document. So you are specifying the system to retrieve all the document having the term library and automation in the title of the document. That is why the number of results decreased. Okay, so in this way you can refine your search. In this way you can refine your search. Suppose you want only scholarly journals. You want result from scholarly journals. Scholarly journal means peer-reviewed journal. Suppose you want publications from peer-reviewed journal. You see, again the result will be less. So only 334. So 1090 was the result. Now it becomes 334 because you chose only peer-reviewed or scholarly journals. Okay, so in this way you can refine the search. Okay, let us come to our presentation. So combine the search term with Boolean operator, the third step of our strategy is combine the term with Boolean or any other operator which is needed. Then run searches in selected resources and review or refine the result. So you have to review whether you are getting appropriate result or not. So many times we fail to retrieve the relevant results. Many times we fail to retrieve the relevant result or useful or quality results. Why? So internet do not have the document. That is the reason. we are not getting quality retrieval or quality document from internet because internet is not having that. Do you think this? Internet is not having quality document? No, internet is having quality document, but we are unable to put appropriate query. Our queries or searching style is poor. Our searching style is poor, or we are putting poor queries. Then problem of synonym, problem of synonyms. So what about synonyms? Suppose I am searching for the term color, searching for the term color, C-O, color is having two spellings, C-O-L-O-R and C-O-L-O-U-R, and you are searching tricolor, you are searching tricolors. Then you are putting the spelling C-O-L-O-R, but quality documents or relevant documents are there with the spelling C-O-L-O-U-R. So one is British spelling, another is American spelling. So you are getting less result. Although good document or quality or relevant documents are there, you are getting poor result because of the synonyms. So in that case, what to do? So you have to use both the terms. You have to use both the terms. So step by step, I'll come to that. I will show you the example. Then next reason of not getting relevant result is because of the deep web. Do you have idea about deep web? How many of you are having idea about deep web? So the documents which are not indexed by the search engine. We are having our popular search engine Google. So Google indexes, every time Google indexes the new content generated by people or websites. So whatever new content generated, this is indexed by Google. So some web pages which are not indexed by the indexer, that is very difficult to search and find. And these web pages are called deep web. Okay, so in today's presentation, I'll cover search techniques in Google because whatever we are going to search, whether you search any reading material, whether you search any open educational resources, we are very much habituated to search with Google rather than going to the exact repository. Or repository for specific discipline, we usually follow or we usually use our popular search engine Google for searching the resources. So that is why I think I will present you the detailed techniques of searching Google. So in today's presentation, I will cover this all. How to search specific phrases, then how to search related terms, then missing words, specific file types. So these will be covered by me. To make this presentation more. So is this visible to you all? So I have demonstrated you with the database how to use AND operator. So here in Google, we do not have the facility of inbuilt AND or not. So we have to type AND operator along with the key phrases. So here you write health problem and air pollution. That means you are instructing the system to retrieve the document which is having the phrase health problem along with the phrase air pollution. You see here. So here someone will type health problem and air pollution. So health problem, some document may be having the phrase health problem and some other documents may be having the term health complication. Some documents may be having the term health complication in place of health problem. So those documents will be blocked. So if you are searching through health problem, then you will get all the documents having the phrase health problem and air pollution. together within the document. But in place of health problem, if the document is having health complication, then those document will be blocked by the system. Google will not provide you the document which is having the phrase health complication. So what to do? So health problem is having the synonymous phrase health complication. So I have to use this operator. You see, this is the appropriate method of searching. Okay. So health problems or health complication, that means we are instructing the system to retrieve all the document with the phrase health problem or health complication. If health problem is there in the document, that is also useful for us. If the document is having that phrase health complication, that is also useful for us. But air pollution must be compulsory in the document. So we are connecting the search like this. So health problem or health complication and air pollution. So and is combining the search and narrowing the result, and or is broadening the result. So or here or connector meant for if the retrieval system is having the document with health problem, that will be retrieved. If the document is having the phrase health complication, that also will be retrieved. So system will not block anything, will get better result. So before you see, here the result was 39 lakh 10,000. Here result was 39 lakh 10,000. Now the result increased. Here it is 39 lakh 90,000. The result has been increased because we used OR operator and we instructed to have documents with these two phrases. Okay. Okay. So this Boolean, so AND or NOT, these are called Boolean operator. So we have already discussed, if you want both the term library and automation in the document, then you can connect these two terms with the AND operator. Okay. Then where to use OR? So you know, digital library, electronic library, virtual library, these are all synonymous phrases. These are all synonymous phrases. So if you will type the phrase digital library, then all the documents on digital library will be retrieved. All the documents on World Wide Web or all the documents on web with the phrase digital library will be retrieved. And all the documents, although those documents are relevant, that documents will be blocked because you are asking only digital library. You are not asking document on electronic library or virtual library. So these three phrases are synonymous. So if you will put digital library connecting with or electronic library connecting with or virtual library, then you will get all the documents with these synonymous terms. So this is the appropriate way of searching. Then Boolean NOT operator. So Google supports all these AND or NOT operators. So suppose you want document on printer. Suppose you are a professional and you want a printer for your office work, and you are interested to know about the printers, features of printer. But when you are typing printer, you are getting more information about cartridge, but you do not want information regarding cartridge. So you have to exclude the result, exclude the search. So printer not cartridge will retrieve all the document on printer, not on the cartridge. Okay. So phrase search. Suppose, so what about this phrase search? Suppose I will put air pollution. Before, I have already presented regarding the searching of health problem and air pollution. Suppose I will write the phrase air pollution with inverted comma and air pollution without inverted comma. What is the difference? We can say if I will put air pollution with inverted comma and air pollution without inverted comma, then what is the difference? So air pollution with inverted comma means I am instructing the system to exactly retrieve the result with the phrase air pollution. So it will, if I am putting with inverted comma, then this will provide me less number of result but useful result. Less number of result but useful result or relevant result. So, truncation search facility in Google is used for searching the document with same origin, terms with same origin. So, education, educate, educated, educating, these are started with the common letter educate. So, I can put educate with star mark or question mark. That depends on the search engine, whether you will use star mark or question mark. Then it will automatically put you the options you want: document on education, educate, educated, or educating. So all in title library automation, all in title library automation. So this is the technique in Google which will restrict the retrieval which are having the document, which are having the phrase library automation in the title of the document. So all in title, if you are putting all in title library automation, then you will get all the document having the phrase library automation in the title itself. So similarly, all in URL search in Google. So suppose you are putting all in URL library automation, then you will get all the document having the phrase library automation in the URL itself. So these are the URL or website address. So these website address are having library automation, the term or phrase library automation is there. So we know if the phrase is appearing in the title and URL, then that document is most useful for us. Then searching within a site. Searching within a site. Suppose I want information regarding the university. Suppose I want information regarding the university. So if I will put university in the Google search box, I will get every type of result. I will get university from the site UGC, I will get university from the individual sites, from the individual people site. Some people might have created their personal web pages and they might have written about university. So I may get some personal diaries having the information regarding university, but these are not authentic sources. These are not authentic sources. So I want information regarding university or colleges from an authentic site. So what shall I do? I will specify Google, or I will specify to my search engine to retrieve the result from a specific site. So university, I want result from ugc.ac.in. So this means we are instructing the system to retrieve all the information regarding the university from the UGC site only. We want information from the UGC site only. So we are instructing to Google, give me information about the university from a specific site, and that specific site is UGC, www.ugc.ac.in. Then we can specify whole class of site, only single site we can specify, as well as we can cite whole class of site. Whole class site means university is an academic institution. So the all sc.in, all academic websites will have authentic information about the university. So I will specify Google to retrieve the information regarding university from the academic sites. From all academic sites, I want information. Then this will provide me the result from all academic sites. Then specific file types. If I want documents on, if I want all PDF documents, then I can type, suppose, information technology, file type PDF. Suppose air pollution, file type PDF. So all PDF documents will be retrieved. So I want air pollution, PPT of air pollution. Then I can type air pollution, file type PPT. I will get all the PowerPoint presentation. Then similar search. Similar search. Suppose I will put HTML tutorial. So HTML is a language. So I want tutorial on HTML. So you know synonymous term of tutorial is guide, manual, reference. So if some document is having the term guide, then that document will not be retrieved. Although the documents are there, very, very relevant documents are there, these will not be retrieved because you are writing the phrase HTML tutorial. You are writing HTML tutorial. So all the document having the term HTML tutorial will be retrieved. So if the document is having HTML guide, HTML manual, HTML reference, then these will not be retrieved by the system. So what to do? So solution is put HTML with this similar symbol tutorial. That means whatever term similar to tutorial, whatever term similar to tutorial. So it is similar tutorial is similar to guide, manual or reference. So I want, we are instructing the system, information system, that we want document on HTML tutorial or HTML guide or HTML manual or HTML reference. So we will get all the relevant or useful document. Nothing will be left. Nothing will be blocked by the system. We'll get everything. Okay. So these are some tips. So these are all some tips of effectively searching the internet. Let us come to searching OERs. Now let us come to search OERs. So let me show you OER commands first. So let us come to OER commands. Let us open the with this. So here, so this is a repository of open educational resources. We are now going to search this repository. So suppose we want document on the topic. Suppose open access. Suppose we want open educational resources on the topic open access. Suppose we want educational resources on the topic open access. So let us type open access and search here. So here in the left hand side, you see these are the levels available. So this is education level. Suppose you want a document for upper level. Suppose it is college and upper level. So these are all OERs, Open Educational Resources. So you can restrict the retrieval to specific license. Suppose you want conditional remix and share permitted. You want, suppose, unrestricted use. You want unrestricted use. So you see the number decreased when you clicked on unrestricted use. The number has been decreased to 95. So you see. So for open access, number of result was 566. 566 was the result. When you restricted to public domain, the number is only 2. So what do you mean by public domain? Can anybody tell me? What do you mean by public domain document, dear participants?
Ma'am, the documents which are available in the open access free of cost, mostly.
All the open access documents are freely available. That is, you do not have to pay for that.
Yeah.
All the open access resources are freely available. You do not have to pay. But what do you mean by public domain document? Are you able to differentiate between open access document and open educational resources? So open access documents means you can download, you can print it, you can share among your friends, or you can share the link of the resources for using. You can share with your friends, you can share any public website, in any public website, you can download, you can copy, you can Xerox it, you can do everything with open access resources. But with open educational resources means you can do all these, whatever you can do with open access. Along with that, you can do remix, you can do derivative work, you can edit the work. So whatever work done by the individual, so whatever written by the author, you can modify the work. You can rewrite the work, you can edit the work. You are having that permission. So public domain document means these are out of copyright documents. These are all out of copyright documents, means you can do whatever with this document. Whatever means you can do derivative of this, you can use it for commercial use. Commercial use means, suppose there is a book, you can modify the book according to your choice. Suppose new knowledge is developed now, you can update the book with new content, then you can sell the book. Selling permission is also with you. So this is called public domain document. So public domain documents are out of copyright books. There is no copyright. Okay.
Okay.
So you are getting less result here. Suppose I am putting license type. Suppose forget about the license, we want all the document on open access. So you see, suppose this is a book of open access by Peter Suber. This is a book of open access by Peter Suber. So this book is fully available to you. The full text of book is available to you and it is open for all. Everyone can read it, use it, modify it, they can edit the book, they can use derivative out of this book. Okay, so you see, this is the book of open access. So here the option is available, you can share this book, you can share this book. So it is another open educational resource on open access. So let us come to view source. So here you see, suppose you are a teacher. Suppose you are a teacher and you found this open educational resource from the OER Common or from any source. You found this open educational resource, or you found a book which is open. This is a open full text book, open for the public. You are interested to share this your students, share to this your students. So this is the option available. You see here, if you click here, directly you will be in the Google Classroom. So by clicking here, you can share it with your students. So you can share these resources with your students or with anyone. You can share these resources via WhatsApp, via Twitter. So open educational resources are very, very flexible. You can do whatever you want with this. Okay. So only thing is, most of the resources, they want attribution. So you have to attribute the individual who have created this. So in this way, you have to search open educational resources. So let me show you Creative Commons. Finding or searching open educational resources from Creative Commons. Okay, are you familiar with Creative Commons? Yes, you are familiar, and I will show you. Suppose I want an image on digital learning. I want a image on digital learning. Okay, so these are the images on digital learning. Suppose I want a image on Google. I want an image on Google. So suppose this image for my academic purpose. Suppose I am writing something about Google. Suppose I am writing an assignment or a project work on Google, or I am writing an article on Google, and I am interested to make use of this image. So this image I will take from this place and I will put in my I will put this in my assignment or title, article, or any material I am writing. Suppose here, very slow. Okay. Suppose I am writing something about Google. I am writing the project on Google, so I will put this image here. Just copy the image. And paste here. So it is taking time. So in between, you may ask some questions. So here, the image of Google is here. and I have to put source from where I found the note. So here the license is there. So here you have to click on copy. So it is copied. Now you have to paste here. So Google by Find You Search is licensed under CC BY SA. SA stands for Sierra Leone. So you can use this image, but you have to attribute like this. Okay, so you have to attribute like this. Put this image. This image was mapped with CCB by license. So it is having most flexible license, CCB by, so copy it. So it is copied. Now you can paste here. So in this way, you can use the educational resources or open educational resources available in the repositories. In this way, you can search and you can use for your academic purposes. So you know, PPG Patsala, all of you know. So here, open educational resources are available with EPD Patsala. So let us see how to access course materials, how to access course material or educational resources from EPG Patsala. So you see here there are different subjects. So for adult education, 190 courses are there, educational materials are there, and like that, architecture, biophysics, education, criminology, biotechnology, these are the different subjects. Okay, so if you want document on the topic, suppose so on which topic you want, let us see an example. Which topic, on which topic you want course material? Suppose on library and information science. So you have to select the topic here. Suppose user study, then you have to select specific thing you want, then you will get all the educational materials. So these are the full text. This will appear here. Full text will appear here. So these are the educational materials. Okay, so in this way you can search OERs or open educational resources. So any questions? I think my time is over.
Ma'am.
Yes.
Hello. Ma'am,
yes.
My name is Nagaya. You already said what is the difference between in the open access and the OER.
Yes.
But I clearly not understand. Please once again you tell the.
Yes.
The,
yes. I
what
will.
Is OER and open access? Yes.
Yes.
Thank you, ma'am.
So open access resources means the resources which are openly available free of cost on internet. Openly available free of cost on internet. You can download it, you can make Xerox copy out of it, you can take a printout, you can make Xerox copy, you can share the resources with public, with others. So you can do this with the resources. So if for academic purpose, you can use this. You can download, you can read, you can make print out of this. Okay, so this is openly available. You can use it, you can read it, but you cannot do derivative work out of this. Suppose a poem is written. Suppose a poem is written, and you are reading that poem, and you found some stanza is not appropriate. Suppose there is a poem regarding your country India, and you found some stanza is missing, and you are interested to add a stanza to that poem. Are you getting me? You are interested to add a stanza to that poem. Okay, but you cannot do this because the poem which is written by the author is not allowing for making the modification of the work. For making the modification of the work, the author is not allowing. But for open educational resources, these are all flexible. They will allow you to do modification. They will allow you for modification of the work. If the poem is not self-sufficient for your country, you can add a more stanza for your country, and you can redistribute that poem. You can redistribute that poem among the people. Suppose I am an author of the poem. I have written 4 stanza, but I have not written a very good important thing about my country, and you have added that stanza to my poem. Okay, so you are the modifier of the poem. So you are the editor, you are the modifier, you are making derivative work of the poem. Okay, so you are
yes.
Now you are getting me, na?
Yes, hello ma'am. Yes ma'am.
Yes. Okay. So
thank you, ma'am. Thank you.
You can make derivative out of the work. So, any more questions?
Ma'am, but we only find the OERs in OER repositories. How do we find some data source is open access and there are OER? When we download the documents or materials in OER repository, we find it. It's OER. It's OER content, but some other content. It's so how do we find the open access and the OER materials? Another
way. Okay. How to identify OER, whether the
yes,
document is OER or not? You have to identify.
Yes, ma'am. Yes.
Very
yes,
good
ma'am.
Question. Very good question. So already yesterday I have demonstrated you. There are many YouTube videos available, and mainly YouTube is a source which is useful for academic as well as for entertainment purpose. Suppose you are interested for an academic video and you want a OER video. OER video, because OER allow for modification of the work, for making derivative work. So how to find OER? So if Creative Commons license is there, if CC license is there, then you'll be sure that it is OER. If CC license is there, shall I show you again?
Yes, ma'am. I saw that, ma'am. CC license.
Okay. So if you will see that it is having CC license. Again, not restrictive license. There is a restrictive license of CC, that is NT and non-derivative and non-commercial license is there. That is not coming under OER. That is not satisfying the 5R of OER. So you know 5R of OER, that is remix, reuse, modify, like that. All 5Rs we are already discussed yesterday. So if the resource is having CC license, that is CC BY or CC BY SS, or like all these licenses there, then it is an OER. You can say it is an OER. Then from OER common, I have already demonstrated you na how to search OER commons. So OER commons indexes all the open educational resources. OER common indexes all the open educational resources. So whatever resource you will get from OER, these are all open educational resources. You do not have to test whether these are OER or not. When you are searching common sources like YouTube is a common source. All resources are there. That may be open, that may be closed, whatever, that may be open access, that may be OER, whatever may be. So you have to check there. But when you are checking dedicated OER repository, like OER Common, that is a dedicated OER repository. So whatever resources we will get from OER Common, that is OER. You do not have to test whether it is OER or not. Are you getting me?
Yes, ma'am. I get it, ma'am.
Yes.
Thank
so
you,
if
ma'am.
You are, yes. So if you are searching Google, advanced search option of Google, and you are interested for finding OER. So yesterday I have already demonstrated. Shall I repeat it again?
No, ma'am.
Okay, okay, okay. So, are you clear about OER and open access? Is it clear to all?
Yes, ma'am. I understand.
Okay, okay, okay. So, any more question or we'll close here? So, Lily Sahu, any question? You have raised your hand. Someone, Lily Sahu, you have raised your hand. Okay, okay.
No, I'm not.
So, Abhijit ji, shall I left? Shall I leave the meeting?
Okay, ma'am.
Okay, thank you all for your patience hearing, and thanks, Abhijit sir and Annam sir for giving me the opportunity. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am, very much.